So anything out there which is successful is successful because of a reason. It serves a purpose. It solves a problem. And the same is true for all the programming languages around us. So when it comes to programming languages, people are generally concerned about top 5, top 10 programming languages. But there are more programming languages which exist today. And they exist because it solves a problem, otherwise they wouldn't. And this video is not about ranking programming languages. I don't believe in that, and I don't think that's a great idea. But as a software developer, as a programmer, as an architect, we struggle with choices because there are a hell lot of choices. Which programming language to choose, which programming language to learn, which programming language to use in our project or product, and what should be best for whatever we want to achieve. Unfortunately, there is no black and white answer for this. But in this particular video, I am going to give you some filters which you may apply to find out what is suitable for the work which you want to do, not what you want to learn. You can learn anything based on any environmental circumstances or regions. But this is all about what you should select for your work, the product you want to create. Now, in here, I will talk about languages I am acquainted with, and I have categorized them in 3 types. Okay, I can't talk about all other languages, but I do believe that they will fit into one of these categories. So category 1 consists of languages which are compile time without garbage collectors. C, C++, Rust. Category 2 is compile time languages with garbage collector. C Sharp, Go, Java. Category 3 is mostly about interpreted language like JavaScript and Python. So these are the 3 categories of languages. Now let's apply some filters for selection. The first filter is inherent bias. So if we know only one programming language, well, then decision is done. Whatever we want to do, we may end up doing the thing in that particular programming language. Nothing wrong in it, but as a programmer, as a software developer, if you want your programming skills to be complete, please learn more than one programming language. And if you can learn one from each category, that would be great. Now, if you manage to pass through this inherent bias filter, we can apply performance filter. Now, this is a bit tricky. Category 1 languages can give you highest possible performance, followed by category 2 and then category 3. Now, this is not an easy choice because whenever you ask a customer or a client, they will not say that, okay, you know, even if I'm not getting better performance, that's okay. Everybody wants a highly performant code, highly performant software. But this doesn't mean that you always select category 1 because there are inherent limitations. Now, this particular filter might help you in analyzing your situation in a better way, but may not help you in taking the decision. To take a decision, you need to apply 2 other filters. The first filter you need to apply on this is that how much time it will take. Now, category 1 languages will take more time to write or create a software because it's just a programmer's playing field. You have to take care of everything. Even though Rust is relatively better in terms of memory safety, but still, I believe that it will take more time to create something, you know, which is really amazing. Followed by category 2, followed by category 3. Now, if you want to make something really fast, category 3 language is a choice you can take. But you have to take a hit on performance. Again, the choice is not easy because does it really matter? You need to understand this. For example, if you are creating some front end, if category 1 languages can give you something in 100 milliseconds, and category 3 gives you in, let's say, 200 milliseconds. For a human, it might not make a lot of difference. But if you are creating some backend system and you want to serve hundreds of thousands of customers as soon as possible, then this makes a huge difference. So you need to carefully apply this filter to come up with a conclusion. And the other filter you will apply is the skills of your team as well as yourself. Which language you are comfortable with. Is it belongs to category 1, category 2, or category 3? Ideally, it will be a great thing if you as a programmer knows at least one language from category 1, category 2, and category 3. Okay, because then you can make a wide choice. And unlike what other people might think, I don't consider learning programming languages such a hard thing to do. Okay, it's not that hard if you have a problem to solve. You know, take a problem, solve in any particular language, you learn that language in a faster way. But still, in terms of category 1, 2, and 3, if you know a category 1 language, it's easy to learn category 2 language. And if you know something in category 2, it's easy to learn category 3. But if you have started with category 3 language, it will be difficult to learn category 2 or category 1 language. But it's neither too difficult nor impossible. So do not just give away because you don't know it. People generally ignore intangible benefits. Everybody is running after tangible benefits. Intangible benefit could be if your selection is wise, selection is proper. You may, you know, save hundreds and thousands of hours in bug fixing, improving performance, you know, making sure there is no deadlock, making sure that no corruption memory error is happening, no memory leak is happening. All those things will take a hell lot of time, much more time that it will take for you to learn a programming language. So these are some of the filters you can apply for your work, for your product. Okay. And I do believe that if you apply these filters and make a wise selection, it will give you immense intangible benefits that will lead to tangible outcomes. I do hope and believe that I gave some idea about how to select a programming language in this particular video. Thank you all. Thanks for watching.